Welcome to Philosophy 4, Knowledge at Las Positas College. This is Module 2, Lecture 1.1 on Plato's Meno. This reading can be found in your textbook, which is entitled Human Knowledge by Paul K. Moser. The selection is on pages 33 to 38. Plato was born sometime around 428 BCE in Athens, Greece. He was the most important and impactful student of the earlier Athenian philosopher, Socrates. Socrates himself is perhaps most famous for stating that, quote, the unexamined life is not worth living. Socrates was put to death by the Athenian state for encouraging the youth to question their parents and for challenging the religion of Athens. After the death of Socrates, Plato continued to write in the voice of Socrates. As time goes on, Plato probably drifts further and further from the real beliefs of Socrates and uses the voice of Socrates more and more to promote his own views. This dialogue is referred to as the Meno because in this dialogue, Socrates discusses philosophy with his friend Meno. As in all of Plato's dialogues, eventually Socrates convinces his skeptical friend that he is correct by using a series of philosophical proofs. In our selection from the Meno, knowledge is really remembering. We don't start with a blank slate as infants and then learn from the world. Instead, he believes, we existed with immense knowledge before we were born, and life just reminds us of the truths that we already knew. Meno is understandably skeptical that all knowledge is really remembering, but Socrates claims he can prove it. Socrates calls a boy who had been a slave in Meno's house since his birth, so Meno knows that the child had never been educated to understand the principles of mathematics. After confirming that the boy has not been taught mathematics, he asks a series of questions about the nature of squares. The series of leading questions allows the boy to figure out, for example, that the length of a square that is 2 feet tall and 2 feet wide has an area of 4 square feet. Obviously, the textbook author translates the Greek units into feet for our convenience. But then Socrates and the boy begin a discussion about how to double the size of a square. The boy believes that if you doubled the length of both sides of the square, you would double the area of the square. This gives fuel to Meno's claim that the boy does not already know mathematics. So Socrates begins again with more leading questions. He tells the boy to imagine that he took the existing square and then drew an additional square like this so that it fits around the original square with the points of the original square touching the center lines of the new square. Once that is complete, he asks the boy about the relationship of the 4 outer triangles, represented by this one in blue, to the 4 inner triangles, represented by this one in brown. The boy realizes that each inner triangle has a correspondingly equivalent outer triangle, and ultimately realizes that this is how you double the size of a square, not, as he originally thought, by doubling the size of every line in the square. Meno is impressed, but Socrates is not trying to prove that he is a good math teacher. After all, Socrates does not believe in learning, only in remembering. The reason that Socrates quote-unquote teaches the boy through a series of leading questions is because Socrates is trying to prove to Meno that the boy already has knowledge, he just needs some guidance to remember it. Socrates ends this section of the dialogue by saying that because there is no learning, only remembering, we must also be eternal beings, who existed with our knowledge before we were born to earth. We will see more of Socrates' explanation and attempted justification of these claims in later lectures.